As church leaders gather in Rome to address all of the issues around clergy sex abuse, five Catholic women, all seminary professors, sent recommendations to U.S. bishops last month. They include immediate actions to train and protect seminarians when it comes to sexual abuse or harassment. Joining me now by Skype is one of the co-authors of those recommendations, Dr. Susan Selner-Wright, the Archbishop Charles Chaput, Chair of Philosophy at St. John Vianney Theological Seminary in Denver. Dr. Selner-Wright, welcome to our broadcast.
Thank you very much.
Many in our audience might not know that women teach in seminaries, so your viewpoint is unique to this abuse crisis. How important is it to have women influence priestly formation?
Well, it's vital, and the church itself has recognized that. I've been teaching here at St. John Vianney since 2001, so it's not like it's a new phenomenon. But it is an important one, and I think it's one of the ways in which the church in the U.S. can help the church around the world to see the importance of all the people of God and the different states of life coming together to form the priests who then in turn serve the body of Christ.
On your list of recommendations that the five of you sent in, the first is an immediate internal review of all seminaries. Now, an investigation happened already in 2005. So what are you proposing that's different?
Well, a visitation did occur in 2005, and a lot of good came out of that, and we definitely recognize that. And the whole heightening of awareness around these issues since the Dallas Charter in 2002 also, it cannot be underplayed. It's not like we haven't made any progress. We certainly have. But part of what we now know much more vividly, thanks to former Cardinal McCarrick, is that in addition to the protection of minors, we need to be very deliberate about our protection of seminarians and about making sure that we're forming seminarians in such a way that they're more apt to embrace celibate chastity as the life-giving real source of their happiness, really, in their priestly ministry, in a more deliberate way.
You say that obedience and docility are important qualities in seminary, and yet too much emphasis contributes to clericalism. So how can that balance be struck?
Well, it's just like all other balances that we have to pay attention to people in the moment where they are. And, you know, it's very interesting to spend time with seminarians because they're so filled with this desire to offer their lives. And they want to be obedient to God, and they want to learn the habits of being with others in a way that fosters that obedience to God, but they're also learning to become spiritual fathers. And spiritual fathers have to know how to lead with authority. They need to know how to speak to others in authority in a way that is calm and polite, but also sometimes quite firm. And so there needs to be a balance of that everywhere for everyone in the church, but most particularly for those who are preparing to be priests.
Dr. Susan Selner-Wright, thank you for joining us, for sharing your insights as Catholic women who teach in seminaries. We appreciate your time.
Thank you very much.